I don't, wouldn't want to say persuadable, but certainly whose affiliation might be up for grabs, comes from the often highly literate, highly intelligent people who gravitate to the alt-right, internet savvy, media savvy, who often are radicalized in that way, who swallow the red pill, as the saying goes, the illusion from the Matrix. When they are exposed to the first time to true statements that have never been voiced in college campuses or in the New York Times or in respectable media, that are almost like a bacillus to which they have no immunity. And they are immediately infected with both a feeling of outrage that these truths are unsayable and no defense against taking them to what we might consider to be rather repellent conclusions. And let me give you some examples. So here is a fact that's going to sound ragingly controversial, but is not, and that is that capitalist societies are better than communist ones. Okay, so if you doubt it, then just ask yourself the question, would I rather live in South Korea or North Korea? Would I rather live in West Germany in the 1970s or East Germany or in the 1960s? So this is not, I submit that this is actually not a controversial statement, but in university campuses, it is considered, would be considered flamingly radical. Number two, here's another one. Men and women are not identical in their life priorities, in their sexuality, in their tastes and interests. Again, this is not controversial to anyone who is even glanced at the data. The kind of vocational interest tests of the kind that your high school guidance counselor gave you have been given to millions of people. And men and women give different answers as to what they want to do for a living and how much time they want to allocate to family versus career and so on. But you kind of you can't say it. I mean, someone, a very famous person on this campus did say it. And we all know what happened to him. And he's no longer, well, he is on this campus, but no longer in the same office. Here's a third fact that is just not controversial, although it sounds controversial, and that is that different ethnic groups commit violent crimes at different rates. You can go to the Bureau of Justice Statistics, look it up on their website. The homicide rate among African Americans is about 7 or 8 times higher than it is among European Americans. And terrorism, go to the global terrorist database and you find that worldwide the overwhelming majority of suicide terrorist acts are committed by Islamist extremist groups.